Assalamu alaikum. In the name of Allah, the Beneficent, the Merciful, respected viewers, brothers and sisters in Islam, peace and blessings of Allah be upon you all. Welcome to Morals and Minutes. This is Muhammad Ali, and now we are to talk about cheating. Regardless of one religion, there are certain characteristics that are forbidden while others are recommended. The negative characteristics go against what our instincts believe, and it is through our constant sinning that even our instinct and our belief in goodness seem to vanish. Cheating is extremely condemned and looked down upon in Islam. Intentionally destroying the truth in order to mislead others contradicts the values of honesty, which requires an attitude of sincerity, straightforwardness, and fairness that leave no room for cheating, lying, trickery, or deceit. There are many texts from the Holy Quran conveying the meaning that cheating, whether the target be Muslim or non-Muslim, is forbidden. In the Holy Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "Woe to al-mutaffifin, those who give less in measure and weight, those who, when they have to receive by measures from men, demand full measures, and when they have to give by measures or weight to other men, give less than due." If one were to look at the core belief of Islam, they would surely come to conclude that the religion of Islam strives to build a society that is based on purity of love and sincerity towards every Muslim. Its members are endowed with piety, truthfulness, and fearfulness. Cheating and deception are alien characteristics in contrast to the noble character of a true Muslim. Imam Ali alayhi salam, regarding cheating, has said, "The cheater has a sweet tongue and a bitter heart. One should steer clear from all various forms of deceit and deception in present today's society. Cheating is common in examination, business, transactions, and even between spouses and loved ones. Placing a label on domestically made products to make it seem that it is imported is a kind of fraud. Some people give wrong advice when their counsel is sought, and thus deceive the person who believes he is getting a good advice. An employee should do the job for what he is paid for without any deception or cheating. Therefore, a Muslim who has true Islamic sensitivities avoids deceit, cheating, treachery, and lying, no matter what benefits or profits such activities might bring him, because Islam considers those guilty of such deeds to be hypocrites." With this said, respected viewers, we reach the end of our show for now. Thank you very much indeed for watching, and don't forget the dua to hasten the reappearance of the master of our time, His Majesty Imam al-Mahdi. May Allah hasten his reappearance. Stay tuned for more morals. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.